Fibonacci numbers again. Start 1, 1, 2, 3, 5. And the rule is, if each number here equals the ones before it. So if this was the nth number, and we're going to call that xn for the nth number, it equals the one before it plus the one before that. So it equals xn minus 1 plus xn minus 2. So that's our defining thing. And what we're trying to find, ultimately, is what is the ratio between two of the numbers. But importantly, because we're looking for the ratio it is approaching in the limit, it doesn't matter which two terms. It should be the same ratio, give or take, and, you know, if you do it for infinitely many, the same ratio for all of them, but sort of for any two of the terms. So what we can say now is the ratio between x to the n and the one before that, which was x to the n minus 1, one before, should equal the same as the ratio between xn minus 1 to the one before that, which was xn minus 2. And we're going to call it, what letter would you like, Brady, for any Greek letter? Do you have a favorite?
Delta.
Okay, so let's do a capital delta because it's quicker to draw. So we're trying to work out this ratio delta is, and we know it's the ratio between any two consecutive terms. Now we know, according to our relationship which generates this sequence, that xn equals the two before it added together. So I'm going to put that in instead of x. So all I've done is substitute that in. But now I can start simplifying because I've got the same term there twice. So in fact, if I divide through, that's 1 plus x to the n minus 2 over x to the n minus 1, which still equals x to the n minus 1 over x to the n minus 2, which still equals the ratio delta we're looking for. So now, you'll go, hang on a second, that is the same as this, but upside down. And in fact, that equals that ratio delta. So I can now change this to be 1 plus, well, that's the inverse of this ratio, so that's 1 over delta equals, and that there is the delta. And so the relationship for the ratio of any sequence where you get the next term from adding the two previous ones, 1 plus the inverse of that ratio equals the ratio. You're like, well, what ratio could that possibly be? Well, let's work it out, because we can turn this into a quadratic. If I multiply through by triangle, it equals that plus 1 equals triangle squared. And so delta squared minus delta minus 1 equals 0. So all I've done is rearrange that formula. Now we can solve this using our friend the quadratic equation, because we know that if you have a times x squared plus bx plus c equals 0, then x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a. So we can substitute in to use the quadratic formula. So we now know delta equals negative b, which is the coefficient there, which will be 1, plus or minus the square root of b squared is going to be 1 minus 4 times 1 times negative 1, so it's going to be plus 4, 2 times 1 is 2. So that's going to equal, now I'm only going to use the positive for now, 1 plus root 5 divided by 2, which is the golden ratio. If you actually work that out, that's where 1.6180 blah comes from. And in fact, that's one of the definitions of the golden ratio. And so that's why, for any starting terms, it always approaches that same sequence. If you use the negative, you get the negative inverse of the golden ratio. Another wonderful property of it. If I'd used equals 1 minus root 5 over 2, then that equals negative 0.6180 blah. So they're the two solutions for that particular equation. So that's why it works for any sequence where you add two terms to get the next one.
So the Fibonacci numbers meant nothing there.
The Fibonacci numbers are one of a infinite family of such numbers, because for any two whole numbers you want to start with, the exact same thing works out. In fact, why use whole numbers? Go bananas. At no point did I specify whole numbers here. It just, whatever you start with, add two terms, you get the next one, you always get the golden ratio. That's not some special property Fibonacci numbers have. All of them have got that property. We want a better link. What we really want is a sequence of numbers which have a link to the golden ratio that other sequences don't get. We want something above this.
And the Brady numbers.
The Brady numbers are wonderful, but I can go slightly better. So I'm going to show you the Lucas numbers. I personally am a massive golden ratio skeptic. I think it's hugely overrated.